Good evening. Yeah, welcome to another edition of Import Export Platform brought to you by 13 Pest Trade Academy. This is a program that educates our listeners in various areas of international trade, especially as related to export. We commence discussion on why you need to join the export team. For a while now, Adewole Adeshio, thank you very much for joining. Good evening, you are welcome. You are the first to join this evening. Thank you very much for joining. We started discussing why you need to join the export team, and we've been talking about that for a while now. And basically, what we are trying to do is to make people realize the fact that if we are going to rescue this economy, we need to grow export. And that export does not necessarily mean that you have to be the one to export the goods or to manufacture the goods, and that you can export services also, and that you can render support services to exporters. So we put a lot of content and information out there just to help people who are interested in doing this. So I will be talking about, I will continue from where we stop this evening. You know, we started from A, avoid AIDS and manipulation that come with it. And what we are saying with that is that when we export, we avoid AIDS and manipulation that come with it. Aid from those that want to give us aid. But when they give us aid, there are other manipulations that come with the aid they are giving us. By manipulation, I mean they have other motives. They don't just give you aid for fun. Number two is to boost foreign reserve. That's one of the reasons we went into recession, because we don't have enough dollar to fund our importation, and that slowed down the economy. Government does not have enough money to spend, and more important, because government generates their money mainly from export of crude, government does not have enough money to spend, and more importantly, manufacturers also could not import raw material easily, and that's what led us into recession. Why you need to join the export team: to create opportunity for SME to grow. And D, to decrease dependence on domestic market and make it to look for export market. E, to extend the product life cycle, enhance the production capacity and usage of excess capacity. F, to make farming and rural life become more lucrative. G, to gain global market share. H, to make Nigeria home of creativity and innovation. I, to industrialize Nigeria via the back door, because export is industrialization's catalyst. J, for job creation and poverty eradication. K, to know the value of what we have as competitive advantage. L, to lead the way for other African nations. M, to help export, for exporter to make more profit, more profitability for exporter. N, to enjoy the numerous incentive of government. O, it's an opportunity to maximize the value of Nigerians abroad who can act as agent to help create market. And P, to produce what we consume and consume what we produce. Q, to quit the league of developing nation and move on to developed nation. R, redemption of Nigerian image. Courtesy, the PR done by the product we are producing that is marketing us. Now I'll move on to S. To slow down rural-urban migration. To slow down rural-urban migration. Charles Obiora, thank you very much for joining. Good evening and welcome. To slow down rural-urban migration. Do you know that today we have tremendous rural-urban migration? A lot of people in their thousands are coming into Lagos, Port Harcourt, Abuja every day to seek for a better life. Because the village, there's nothing for them there. Whereas in other clients, people want to stay in the interland in the village because they are the engine room producing for the people in the city to manufacture. In fact, a lot of factories are set up close to the villages because they want to set it up near to the source of raw materials. But because we are not adding value and producing, the people are moving away from the village. You know, recently, I wanted to buy a screen protector for my phone and casing. And I was talking to this particular guy, I mean, one of the northern guys that in Lagos that does this regularly. And I was asking, guy, what are you even doing in Lagos? And he said, he doesn't want to be in Lagos, so he doesn't even like Lagos life. But he has to come to Lagos because he was chased out of his farm by the S-men in Benue. So he's actually a Benue guy who is selling phone parts in Lagos because he was chased out. He has to come and look for greener pasture in Lagos. So imagine if there is demand. There is no issue of S-men, number one. There is demand. Great demand for this product abroad. There's great demand for the raw material he's producing. He won't have to come to Lagos. Why will he come to Lagos and be suffering in Lagos when he can be comfortable in the village? When we take export seriously, we are going to increase rural-urban migration. You know, we are basically an agrarian economy. Let me show you some data. The export that was done this year, the export that was done last year, the fourth largest exported item was sesame seed. The fifth largest exported item in 2018 was cocoa. Fourth largest exported item, sesame seed. Fifth largest exported item, cocoa. And that tells you how much. Now, let me tell you other agro commodity that we exported last year. I'm talking about the fourth quarter report. We exported sesame seed that is worth about $33 billion. Cocoa worth $24 billion. Fermented cocoa, $24 billion. Raw cocoa, about $10 billion. Cashew nut, $5.8 billion. Sesame seed oil and fraction, about $4 billion. Frozen shrimps and prawns, about $3.7 billion. Raw cashew nut in shell, about $1.6 billion. Coconut, fresh and dry coconut. You know, it's amazing that Nigeria is now exporting coconut. The coconut, both the one that is shell, the one that has not been shelled, the one that is peeled, the one that has not been peeled. Nigeria exported coconut last year, $1.28 billion. Coconut. Even though these are commodity, I am unhappy we are exporting commodity. But at least it's better that we are not even exporting at all. Now, if you see the volume of this product being exported, these are in billions of naira every year. The list on this top 10 item is $1.2 billion. And that is coconut. That is coconut. Coconut fresh, dry, both shell and unshell. If we are doing a lot of export, if we grow our export volume, we will need more people to produce this thing in the village. And because we need more people to produce this thing in the village, that is going to increase the number of people that want to stay in the village. Because they make more money staying in the village. Why we come to Lagos to suffer? So what happened is, it slows down the rural-urban migration. That reduces the pressure on the infrastructure in the cities. The infrastructure like power, infrastructure like road, all the infrastructure in the city, it reduces the pressure on it. It also makes the people in the city to reduce, the cost of living is lesser because the demand is lower. The demand is lower. The cost of, can you see the ripple effect of just thinking of exporting? Can you see the ripple effect? That if we export a lot of, if we do a lot of export of commodities and the demand for commodity grows, and a lot of people are now processing commodities. And people in the village are making more money than people in the city. People in the city will have to go back to the village and go and join the people in the village to produce. And when that happens, the pressure reduces on infrastructure in the city. The pressure in the city reduces because demand also goes down in the city. And the cost of living in the city goes down. The cost of living in the city goes down. Just because we have increased the rate of production of sesame seed, of cocoa beans, of cashew nut, of frozen shrimps, of coconut. What am I saying in essence? That export alone has what it takes. Just that we accept responsibility to begin to export alone has what it takes to slow down rural-urban migration. Has what it takes to slow down rural-urban migration. And this is very, very important. Very, very, very important. The opportunities we have, the opportunities we have to be able to export. And if we maximize those opportunities, what we can get out of it is amazing. It's amazing. It's interesting what we can get out of it. The ripple effect we can have on this nation. So I'm saying the reason why you need to join the export team. You know, someone sometimes ago actually asked me, why do we even need to export? You know, when I saw that question, I can't blame the person. The person is asking a sincere question, but I can also see his heart and how much knowledge gap we have in our society and the need for this kind of program where we talk regularly about the need for us to begin to export. About the need for us to begin to export. And that if we take exportation much more seriously, Nigeria will be better off. Just the way China has been better off. Just the way China has been better off. Nigeria will be better off at the end of the day. So I'm saying today that we need to take exportation much, much more seriously in order to slow down the rural-urban migration. Because of the potential, and I've just read to you statistics that shows the quantum, in terms of monetary terms, the quantum of shipment that left Nigeria to different parts of the world in year 2018, just the last quarter of 2018. Just the last quarter of 2018, the quantum of shipment that left Nigeria, even though it's still small compared to what we can do, because even with that, we still have a lot of post-harvest losses. We still have a lot of post-harvest losses. Even with that, we still have a lot of post-harvest losses. And the implication of that post-harvest losses is the fact that we can export more than what we are exporting right now. We can export more than what we are exporting right now. If only, we can take export more seriously. The next one is T. There are tax-free opportunities for exporters. That if you take export seriously, you have tax-free opportunities. And I want to go through some of them. I've opened now. What I am looking at now is the Company Income Tax Act. And I'm trying to bring up to fore some of what that law says. Now, it says, interest payable on any loan granted by a bank from April 1980 for the purpose of manufacturing goods for export shall be exempted from tax on the presentation of a certificate issued by the Nigerian Export Promotions Council stating that the level of export specified has been achieved by the company. I'm reading from Company Income Tax Act. So, these are not my idea. These are not what I feel. This is the law of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. The law is saying there is interest-free for banks. Tax-free on the interest that bank generates. So, a bank's interest income on export is exempted from tax in Nigeria. Can you beat that? A bank interest income is exempted from tax in Nigeria. A bank interest income is exempted from tax in Nigeria. If a bank give a loan on export, that the interest is charging on that loan, the tax is supposed to pay to the federal government is exempted from it. Can you beat that? That's the opportunity. That means banks should find it easier, more comfortable to export. Banks should find it easier and more comfortable to finance export, rather. And they should not be pricing export very high. Banks should not be pricing it. A lot of banks are not aware of this. A lot of bankers, from the MD to the cleaner, a lot of bankers are not aware of this. I've confronted a lot of banks. Whenever they hear this, they will say they want to go and check. They want to go and tell their people. They don't know. They are funding export and they are charging a premium in terms of interest and they are paying tax. But the law says that loan for export, as long as you can show evidence in Nigeria's Promotion Council, and the Promotion Council can attest to the fact that this bank earned this interest based on this particular export, that bank will be exempted from loan, from tax. Look at another one. The profit of anybody, corporate, being a purchasing authority. Sorry, I'm coming. Sorry, I'm trying to get that. I'm trying to get another one, so just 1 minute. Because there are a couple of them here. Okay, profit exemption from tax. Profit exempted from tax. Profit exempted from tax. Let me look at the second, another one. It says, dividend received from investment in wholly export-oriented business is exempted from tax. Dividend received from investment in wholly export-oriented business is exempted from tax. Look at another one. Profit of any Nigerian company in respect of goods exported from Nigeria, provided that the proceeds of such export are repatriated into Nigeria and are used exclusively for purchase of raw materials, plant equipment, and spare parts, such profits are exempted from tax. Can you beat that? Can you beat that? Can you beat that? There are numerous incentives for export that many are not aware of. It is right here in our laws, the tax incentive that an exporter enjoys by virtue of exporting. I'm telling you the reason why you need to join the export team. The reason why you need to take export more seriously. The fact that there are enabling laws to make us enjoy the benefit of exportation. A lot of countries are doing this also. Because government in Nigeria is only able to survive on crude export. No nation can survive without selling stuff outside. Added by your grace, Amarachi, thank you very much for joining. No nation can survive. You must export. And government, these are military governments, know this one. And they know the implication of tax. This is not for democracy. So you can imagine how a democratic government should think. Why we should take it a lot seriously. I am of the opinion we are not taking export seriously the way we should take it in Nigeria. The profit of any Nigerian company in respect of goods exported from Nigeria is exempted from tax, provided the export proceeds came back into Nigeria. And that proceed is used for purchase of raw materials, plant, equipment, and machinery. Either your grace says tax exemption from banks means that the country is promoting exportation as a body. Yes, our laws are promoting exportation, but the challenge is that many people are not even aware of what the law says. Many people are not aware of what the law says. Look at another one. The profit of a company whose supplies are exclusively input to manufacturing of products for export. The profit of a company whose supplies are exclusively input into manufacturing of products for export, provided that the exporter shall give a certificate of purchase of the input of the exportable goods to the seller of the supply, the profit of that company who is supplying an exporting company is exempted from tax. I'm reading, these are not my idea or opinion, I'm basically reading from the Company Income Tax Act, CITA. You can check it up. I mean, go online, you can search for it and look at it yourself. So these are not my view, these are not my opinion, these are the laws of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. These are the laws of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. Why do you need to join the export team? To enjoy the numerous tax incentives that the laws has provided. Someone is asking a question, does tax exemption also affect an individual who is involved in export? Or is this solely for organization? Of course, you can only export in Nigeria as a company. You cannot export as an individual. So it's definitely for organization. Thank you very much, Grace, for that question. You can only export as a company. You can export as a limited liability company. You cannot export as a business name. You cannot export as an individual. Even though if you do it, it will be recognized. It must be exported as a company. Look at another company exempted from tax. Profit of a company established within the export processing zone or free trade zone, provided 100% of such company is for export. Otherwise, it will have to pay export. If I set up a business in the export processing zone in Nigeria, by virtue of setting up a business in the export, in the free trade zone, just the way Dangote is doing right there at in the Lekki free trade zone. If I'm exporting from there, I produce 100% for export. I am exempted from tax. I am exempted from tax. Sorry, I'm looking for more. There are more. There are still some. The profit of any body, any corporate body, being a purchasing authority established by an enactment and empowered to acquire any commodity for export from Nigeria, from the purchase and sales of that commodity. If I am a commodity exporter and I am a licensed exporter, registered company in Nigeria, the profit of that corporate body is exempted from tax. The profit of a corporate body who is exporting commodity from Nigeria is exempted from tax. Is exempted from tax. Now, so you can see a lot of tax exemption for businesses in Nigeria. It's interesting to know how much exemption we have from tax as businesses operating in Nigeria. And I'm saying, why do you need to join the export team to be able to enjoy all the benefit? All the benefit. All the benefit of all the benefit of export. All the tax exemption benefit of export. I'm trying to look for more. So basically, we've seen a couple of benefits we enjoy by virtue of being an exporter in Nigeria, and that's very important. And what the point I was trying to make basically is to let you understand and realize the fact that by virtue of being an exporter in Nigeria, you enjoy a lot of tax relief. You can legally do your business and be exempted from tax and taxes by virtue of the fact that you have taken responsibility at a level. Responsibility to go into export. Responsibility to go into export. Why do we need to export? To enjoy tax incentive offered by the federal government of Nigeria for all the exporters in Nigeria. Why do we need to export? So I'm going to round up here today. I'm at tea. I will continue from you tomorrow. And I'll be talking about other benefits of export. Other things we need to look at in exporting. How valuable export is. Why it's important for us to join the export team. Remember, for you to join the export team, you can easily acquire skill to either export goods or export services or render support services to exporters. And all you need to do is to join the training program, the certification program offered by the American Institute of Extended Studies on the Executive Diploma in Export Business Management and the Executive Diploma in Export Trade Finance. And this is extremely, extremely important. Because at the end of the day, when you acquire skill, you build competence. With competence, you can solve problems. When you solve problems, you create value. And when you create value, you attract wealth. Thank you very much for listening again this evening. My name remains Dela Yemibo from the 3TIMPES Trade Academy. And this is 3TIMPES Import-Export Platform Facebook Live. We'll be on again tomorrow morning by 8 a.m. Thank you very much for listening and have a very good evening.